Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
We're talking about love today. I'm here, fair Juliet.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Shall I let my hair down so that you can climb up?
No, I think you've got the wrong...
Everyone, and welcome to CAMSA Connect, your weekly worship service from Cambridge Salvation Army here in the UK. This week, we're celebrating our third birthday.
Hey, we're three, Leanne, and we've practically reached toddlerhood. What about that? And it's Mothering Sunday too, everyone, so we're celebrating all those in the world who fulfil the role of a mother.
That's right. Our theme this week is a mother's love, and we're considering how God's love for every person in the world propels us to love others too. It's all about a little bit of love.
That's right, and we say thank you to our ladies for getting us off to a great start with that song at the start of today's episode. Well, coming up in today's celebratory episode, we have music from our worship band, a story for the children from Davinia, and a special Mother's Day video featuring some of the CAMSA family ladies.
Also, you'll want to stick around until the end of this bumper episode because we have some special birthday messages to show you too.
And, drum roll please, Leanne is leaving us for a few weeks too. So we'll tell you more about that later on.
Indeed. First though, what better way to celebrate the goodness of God and mums and loved ones everywhere than by singing For the Beauty of the Earth. Please join us as we sing.
Thank you.
So today we're thanking God for the joy of human love. A family is a special gift, and we hope you feel part of God's family today as we share together in this way. And we also thank you for being part of the CAMSA family.
Yes, thank you so much for your support these past 3 years. We have felt the love of God through your words of encouragement and emails, your messages and your prayers too.
So let's spend a few moments thinking about God's amazing love and how it's been shown to the world in his son, Jesus. The words of the song we're about to share together say this.
Amazing love, oh what sacrifice the Son of God given for me. My debt he pays and my death he dies that I might live. You may want to say a prayer as we sing together, Amazing Love.
Hello. I hope you've all wished your mums a happy Mother's Day and have done something special for her today. Mother's Day is a day to show love and thanks to all our wonderful mums everywhere. We can show this by doing acts of kindness or giving flowers or giving gifts. do you know where the meaning of Mother's Day or Mothering Sunday came from? Well, way back as far as the Greeks, they would celebrate Rhea, the mother of gods and goddesses, and every spring there would be a festival of worship. Mothering Sunday began with a religious purpose, which was held on the fourth Sunday in Lent. It originally was to give honour and thanks to Mary, Mother of Jesus. Celebrations required people to visit their mother church, or the main church of their family. This celebration was put on the calendar, and this gave people the opportunity to reunite their families and have a family occasion. Adults and children as old as 10 who worked in domestic servants were given the day off and were allowed to travel home to see their mums on this day. As they walked down the country lanes, they would pick up wildflowers so they had a gift for their mums. So this is why we give our mums flowers, chocolates or other gifts on this day. So today, try and remember to be extra kind to mum. Do things for her instead of her doing everything for you. Give her a hug and tell her that you love her. Here is a little poem to help us to remember our mothers. M reminds us of her marvellous love. O reminds us, I have one mother. T reminds us of her tender love. H reminds us of her heart of gold. E reminds us of her endless service. R reminds us to remember her not only on Mother's Day, but every day of the year. God bless you all.
We are grateful to Davinia for reminding us, among other things, how to be nice to our mums. Hello everyone. In case you hadn't noticed, the big day has arrived. As well as it being Mothering Sunday, CAMSA Connect is 3 years old. And I was going to sing Happy Birthday for you all to enjoy, but as my singing voice sounds a bit like a creaking gate at the moment, I'll spare you that pleasure. Just a reminder that the limited edition of CAMSA Connect 3rd anniversary badges that we have been mentioning will only be available until the end of March. So if you would like one, then just send a message to badge@camsa.org.uk and one of our team will call you back to take your details. We hope that you visit our website now and again, where you can find details of our weekly activities. And although the weather is now improving, we are still open for the warm welcome campaign, and availability times for all of these are shown on our website, details of which are in the video description below. In case you weren't aware, our charity shop, Sally Ann's, is on the same site as our church buildings and our hub. So after visiting the front shop or the barn to the rear, you can pop into our hub for your choice of refreshments. We would love to see you sharing in all age worship with us every Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. Our worship is enhanced on alternate Sundays by the singing of our singing company or songsters, and the playing of our young people's or senior bands. We also have a worship band. Afterwards, we share fellowship over tea and coffee. Thanks to those who sent CAMSA 3rd birthday messages. Make sure you keep watching this episode to the very end, which is when those greetings will be shown. Thanks for watching. Now for something different, we're going to watch a specially prepared Mother's Day montage. Here are some of the CAMSA ladies with Things Mums Never Say. Now can someone point me in the direction of the third birthday cake, please?
Good news, kids. I found a money tree. You can have as much as you want.
Oh, okay. Well, here's my phone charger. You can have that in your room if you want.
It's okay, don't worry about all that food on your plate. You can just leave it.
It's okay. Don't worry about making your bed. I'll do it.
Your room always smells so fresh.
Oh, good. More crisps on the floor.
Raising kids is so easy.
I never have to repeat myself. My kids always listen so carefully.
To be honest with you, I haven't really got that much to do. Wouldn't you be better maybe wearing a shorter skirt or even putting some eyeliner on?
I'm so bored.
Oh no, I'd definitely prefer to be here than at the beach.
When I was a young mother, I always had plenty of sleep.
Mum.
Oh, I love all this mud. Well done for getting stuck in.
I'm not sure I know the answer to that. Your dad usually does everything around here.
Feel free to look through the fridge for the fifth time today.
I know it's winter, but don't worry about a coat. You'll be fine.
Flushing the toilet is completely optional.
That's okay. Don't bother to call me when you get there. I don't need to know you've arrived safely.
Yeah, that's it. Jump on the bed and see how high you can go.
All of these people are such good drivers.
Hey everyone, thanks for doing the washing and ironing.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Well, everybody, let's get our phones out.
Yay!
It's far too quiet in this car.
I'm loving the smell from your feet today.
Oh, I'm loving this back pain.
Don't rush. Take as long as you like. We'll still be there in time.
Thanks everyone for your support in the online offering. Don't forget that other ways to give are listed in the description below.
And thanks to all the CAMSA ladies who helped with the video. Great acting there, girls.
Fantastic. Now, as we mentioned earlier, Leanne is leaving CAMSA Connect just for a few weeks. So Leanne, everybody's wondering, why is it you're leaving?
Well, it's because I will be attending a six-week conference at a place called the International College for Officers, which I'm really looking forward to.
Yeah, and you're going to be in company with lots of officers from around the world down there in London, and you'll have a fantastic time, we're sure. But while Leanne's away, what's going to happen here at CAMSA Connect? Well, you'll be really glad that Annie is going to be joining us to help me with the presenting for the next few weeks. Everything's going to be perfect.
Well, are you sure everything's going to be perfect?
Well, of course, because Annie's a very experienced, you know, person for this kind of thing. She's done it loads of time before.
Yeah, but it's not actually Annie I'm worried about.
Look, don't worry. Everything's all arranged. I have everything totally under control.
Hello.
Hi, Annie. Thanks for agreeing to help Martin while I'm away.
It's no problem. Is there anything in particular that you want me to do?
Well, he's going to need a hand setting up all the equipment because, well, he does get confused easily. And also, you'll have to stand on his right.
Right.
Yeah, that's right. Right. Oh, and he'll need a tall box to stand on. And you know the way he wants to make jokes all the time?
Tell him to leave those to Norman. Yep, got it.
So are we good?
Well, I suppose we are. But are you usually that tall?
Yes, what are you talking about? Of course I am. Well, it's almost time for Leanne's farewell Bible thought as she talks to us about God's love. First, let's hear today's reading, which is from a letter St. Paul wrote to an early Christian church in Colossae, a place which today is found in modern-day Turkey.
And we're glad that here to read from Colossians chapter 3 is one of our CAMSA mums, Margaret.
And today's reading is taken from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 to 17. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord gave you, and over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom, and as you sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen.
And I have been watching The Chosen, a TV series about the life of Jesus and his followers. We're getting a great insight into the world as it was then. It's just wonderful. We really highly recommend it. I have found it engaging, captivating, and it's the sort of thing you want to keep watching. I can't wait till we get to the next episode. And I'm finding it so moving. We see Jesus laugh, cry. We see him walk past those who have been crucified by the Romans. And you watch him look at the people hanging there and you can imagine exactly what he's thinking. That'll be me. The thing that I really love is the look on the actor's face, who's playing Jesus, when he heals or talks to someone about their worth. And I find myself thinking that as Jesus hugged somebody on one particular evening, oh, I would love a hug from Jesus. Well, then I think to myself, well, I can have a hug because I'm reminded that in Scripture we read words that show us just how loved we are. I have loved you with an everlasting love. When you walk through fire and water, they cannot harm you. You are mine. I will never leave you. I forgive you. And we read, don't we, in Scripture, just how much Jesus loved us when he allowed the powers that be to try him and convict him of nothing and then crucify him. He died for you and me, so that we could indeed know how loved we are. And then we read words like this that we heard today in Colossians. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, we are his chosen, loved by him before we knew him. He loved, and not just loved, but dearly loved. That's a wonderful thought, isn't it? A wonderful knowledge to have. It's as good as a hug. But you know, the scripture that we heard today doesn't just end there. We hear more words. And these are great words as we think about Mother's Day and how a mother should love her children and relationships, how they should be in general. Not only are we reminded of how loved we are, but then we are told that we are to clothe ourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience. We are to bear with one another and to forgive one another. These are characteristics that reflect God himself. You see, the great commandment that Jesus gave us tells us that we are to love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, strength, all our mind, and then we are to love our neighbours as ourselves. And this passage from Colossians tells us then how to love each other. Now, I think it's really easy to say, I love you. However, we are asked to show that love to others, just as Jesus showed us how much he loved us. So we are to have compassion, to feel deeply for those who are suffering, and then to take that feeling and to turn it into acts of kindness. So we're friendly, generous, considerate. We listen more than we talk. And we are to do it all with humility. Not to gain recognition or to puff up our own importance. C.S. Lewis defines humility as not thinking less of yourself, but thinking of yourself less. And we're to do so with gentleness. So be mild-mannered, careful in our speech and our actions. And as part of gentleness, we are to be patient. Now that can be a tricky one. You can be driving along the road and you get cut off by another driver. How does your patience do? Or maybe you're sat in a queue or stood in a queue and you've limited time. And the more you stand in the queue, the more irate you can feel yourself getting. Our patience starts to go out the window. Well, scripture here tells us that we are to have patience. And in scripture, patience is more than just waiting for the queue to move or to receive results and the notification of an appointment. Patience is an active word. It can mean that we endure through hardships and difficulties, that we are persevering towards a goal and expectantly waiting for a promise to be fulfilled. That is patience. And then we're told that we're to bear with one another and forgive one another. Not easy at all. But when Jesus says to me and to you, I forgive, he expects that we do it. And not just once or twice, but as many times as is needed. These are the characteristics that the followers of Jesus are expected to have. And Paul then says that we are to clothe ourselves with these things. So each morning, we are to put on these clothes. We are to choose each day to wear the characteristics of God. And we do that by loving God. And as we love him, then we show others his love too. So on this Mothering Sunday, we give thanks for the love from our mothers and we recognise, don't we, the immense love that God has for us. We return that love. How can we not? And then, because of that love, we put on the characteristics that show God. And we do so because it honours him, because it shows the people around us who he is. And we do it all by giving thanks to God the Father.
Please join us in a prayer. Father God, we thank you for your great love for each and every person in the world. Help us to love others too. Maybe not be afraid to give a hug when it is needed.
Lord, clothe us with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience as with each other we seek to build a better world. In your name we ask it. Amen.
And amen. Well, thanks everyone for joining us for this special edition of CAMSA Connect. I'll be back next week with Annie when we'll be thinking about God breathing new life.
Yes, we'll have music, or they'll have music, from our songsters, a cornet solo, and our special guest speaker is Mel.
Great. So in the meantime, don't forget to like the video, if you did like it, that is. Leave us a comment below to tell us where you're from. Consider subscribing here on YouTube, and you can catch us over on Facebook too, so do link with us there.
Well, don't forget to stick around for some birthday messages. But first, let's conclude with a song that celebrates God's faithfulness by asking him to be with us at all times of the day. Until next week, everyone, keep safe, keep well,
and keep connected.
God bless you.
Happy third birthday, CAMSA!
Happy third birthday, CAMSA!
Happy birthday, CAMSA!
Happy birthday, CAMSA! Good morning, CAMSA Connect! Happy third birthday!
And thank you to everyone that's made it possible over the last 3 years.
Happy third birthday, CAMSA!
Happy birthday, CAMSA!
Everyone welcome.
Nobody perfect.
Anything possible.
Happy birthday, CAMSA Connect.
Happy birthday!